Good afternoon. We're back with more DC Dual Force. This afternoon we're going to try a Zatanna Batman deck. I think I've established, well, at least in my own head, that Batman Who Laughs isn't that great. And so I want to try out more the deck that I do think got some help in this new mini set, which is Zatanna with the addition of Morgan Le Fay. I tried out Zatanna and Lex Luthor, and that was quite good. But today we're going to try out Batman. And maybe get a chance to try one of the other new cards. The Tactics Edition. So, let's use the usual slate of energy cards. I'm not a huge fan of Timothy Hunter in Zatanna decks, I've discovered. I think that's good on bronze cards. It's good on silver. And we'll go for gold cards. I would include the Flash, but I've discovered that the magical spells don't count as energy cards. They don't activate the Flash. I don't know if that's a bug or not. And I do think Hellblaze is still very good. But we are out of space. Let's probably have to cut silver. Let's see where we land with the tactics cards, and then we'll come back. Brenda, Chimp, Pablo, so we're at 17. Include one utility belt. There are just way too many good silver cards. I don't think this is a Lucius deck. Every deck is a Robin deck, but what do I remove? Thomas Wayne? I want to include Andrew Bennett. Metron. How does that look? Let's try that. Still can't press spacebar when I'm naming decks. That broke a couple of patches ago. Okay, let's try this out. Beginning the day at rank 8. Well, as usual, we're going for a 4 bronze opening. There are a few exceptions to that rule. Occasionally, I will settle for a 3 bronze, 1 silver opening. if it's the right silver card, if it combos well with a bronze card. But it's rare, and generally if you took the approach of going only for bronze all the time, I don't think you could go wrong. It's a risky play, but he's gonna get away with it. Typically when I play Green Lantern decks, I wait and play Chase Salon on turn number 2. But if you can get away with playing it on turn 1, you can really run away with the game quickly. I think I'm gonna need Nurgle next turn. Just a hunch. Okay. We're in good shape long term. Playing a mono faction energy deck. I tried this deck out. It did okay. Oh wow, he Nurgled me. That is unexpected, because he killed his own Chase Salon, which means he doesn't have any more Green Lanterns in hand. Guess he doesn't have another play in hand at all. Do I Nurgle here, or do I just Green Arrow? I'll Nurgle. I don't think there's gonna be a better spot for it. Though, if I had saved Nurgle for next turn, I could have gotten Jason Blood off, so I probably should have done that. That'd be a mistake in this spot. Interesting. I look for healing in this spot. Okay. Go Robin. So if I'd wanted the Jason Blood, I would have had to Nurgle and then also necromancy would have been okay. Maybe that's the thing I should have done. Don't really mind if Batman dies early if I have really strong card advantage.
I've got a lot more than rabbits in this room.
Where are we at here? Just one? We're gonna go with a lot of options. So Batman would be good, but I don't need card draw. So Metron, I also don't need the card draw. Andrew Bennett, he is the biggest card though and the best chance of actually sticking something to the board. Let's do that, and then let's necromancy hoping to grab Robin. No Robin. Also best chance to defend Batman until I can get another gadget, maybe a heal. Does he have multiple options or no good options? Alrighty. So this could be a Jason Blood turn.
I've got a lot more than rabbits in this room.
Oh, whoops. I didn't realize my hand was full. That was really silly. Let's go Zatara. Oh, there's a Tara. He can come close to KOing me this round. Probably should have played Metron to defend Zatanna and just given up Batman. I did think I had a chance to protect Batman for at least one more cycle, but of course I didn't know he had Zatara. It is possible I'm just dead here. He's currently at 4 each, that's 8 damage. 14, he's 1 off. Oh, now he's not. Yikes, that's a frustrating game. I would say that my deck is just unequivocally better, and there's nothing wrong with my play, I don't think. Maybe it was a little greedy to try to protect Batman. That's what I learned there. It's probably a little greedy. I'd put Metron in front of Zatanna, I think I win. You did get lucky to find the right cards you needed at the right times. Smoke and Mirrors was the thing that saved him there. So I'm not sure that he had the damage otherwise. But I think my own greed cost me that game. No reason to play any of these reactionary cards here. Interesting.
I've got a lot more than rabbits in this time.
Sure. Should have put the detective in front. Nick Necro. Don't think it's Deadshot. Must have been Poison Ivy. Can't see a reason why it would be Deadshot, and I chose Nick Necro because Poison Ivy is not a very common card to see in a deck. Save the energy blast for a target that we can't kill with the hero power. Okay. Pretty straightforward turn. Let's do the trades. That is an anti-fun card.
I've got a lot more than rabbits in this time.
Interesting. Batman's gonna die this round, most likely. If I found a heal, you wouldn't die. All right, so he's out of cards. Wants to do with that attack. Sure. Appetite for conquest has got to be changed, so it says minimum one. Let's try again. Once again, missed. I have no idea what's in his deck, but you can't have appetite for conquest making cards useless. It's got to say minimum one. So you can reduce 2/2 to 1/1, but you can't have 1/1s instantly dying because it invalidates a bunch of bronze cards. Just makes it so they just can't be played. And I think it's got to be changed. It would involve coding, though. So, get in multiple attacks. Is he dead? 11, 12? No, not quite. Oh, right, that can't be attacked. Okay. seen some Hal Jordan decks today. That is not common. Well, now that I have Constantine, I'm going to save the Amethyst, because that Crystal Blast is a magical spell. So, floating two bronze resources, that sucks. See if we can compensate for that. See what we get from Zatanna.
I've got a lot more than rabbits in this
and Batman.
I still have a few tricks on my sleeve.
Okay. Also could have been a Jason Blood turn.
Fully charged.
I'm not sure why he played Ventriloquist there. So doesn't have anything to combo with it. I think I forgot to put Morgan Le Fay in this deck. I'm just now thinking of that. Whoops. I'll remedy that after this game. It's one of the main reasons to play this deck. Nerfed myself for a couple of games. Also think I forgot to do the comic, which is where I assume that card came from. That must be why we're seeing Hal Jordan. Not gonna do that now, I just wanna take a look at the card. Guy Gardner. You may pay bronze to give Guy Gardner and a random Green Lantern in your hand, Flurry. That is not good. Silver for a 5/4 with Flurry and another Green Lantern Flurry yet. That is just not good. There's no way around that. Alright. Need to be at least a 5/5. Definitely want Morgan Le Fay. In fact, I'm not sure I even play this deck without Morgan Le Fay, but. Where did Morgan Le Fay go? What? So that's why I didn't include her. What? Oh wait, that's a tyranny card. That's why she's not in the deck. That's a tyranny card. Oh. Yeah, so Zatanna decks actually didn't get help in this patch. Zatanna and Tyranny decks did. That's okay. I mean, we do have Jason Blood, so I guess that's a little help, right? We'll continue playing it. That's a silly mistake. For some reason, in my head, I thought it was an energy card. Okay, so I get why we're seeing Hal Jordan. That particular Green Lantern adds nothing to a Hal Jordan deck. I'm not even sure I would include him. No reason to play Energy Blast here, we'll save it.
I still have a few tricks up my sleeve.
I've got a lot more than rabbits in this one.
Could it be smoke and mirrors on the Superman robot? That's the best option that I have. Interesting. Doesn't want to use Shazam to attack. Let's see if we can find Pablo. Oh, too bad. And in that case, I have no good plays here except to float two silver resources. It's really bad and probably means that I lose. think almost every character he's played so far is out on aura, except for the Superman robot. Polymorph doesn't do any good.
I still have a few tricks up my sleeve.
He's gonna try to win on a lightning bolt chain. Go full scumbag. Interesting that he's leaving this card up. It's devastating with multiple gold plays.
May the gods grant us their favor.
So Smoke and Mirrors wins the game here. That's pretty good. Oh wait, I forgot about the auras. Whoops. Oh well. Not as good as I thought. That was silly. Well, at least it did exhaust Supergirl, and that does create a problem for him since he can't trade into the Blue Beetle without using his Lightning Bolt. And even so, okay, pop the aura, so that's good. He has to kill both or he's dead. Okay. So maybe the cryokinesis was fine, just even with the auras. It did just enough. I wonder if there was some other streamer that played Hal Jordan Joker. That's not a very common combo. So far at the new cards, Jason Blood, we haven't really had the chance to play. Well, I did have a chance, but I chose to do other things. Andrew Bennett, meh. He's been a big threat. A 6 attack hunter with 6 health. He may have contributed to my opponent conceding in the last game. Is my opponent actually there? Let's go ahead and pause until he does something. May have disconnected. So we'll go ahead and pause till he does something. Okay, he's back. Plays an ambush bug and goes face. All right. Healing.
I've got a lot more than rabbits in this
room. I'll take the polymorph. Could be useful if he tries any Arkham inmate shenanigans. He may be having connection problems. Go ahead and pause. Certainly looks like connection problems. He was able to reconnect for a second and then disconnected again. Would be my guess. Don't really have anything to play here, so I'll draw a card with utility belt. Lightning Bolt. Alfred. 8, okay. And we'll go ahead and pause while the clock runs down. Another Alfred? Okay. Gotta get this stuff out of my hand. I don't think I can actually play this other Alfred. Too many cards. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. Since my opponent's not there, but it's good to practice good mechanics, right? Well, see you in a couple minutes. Okay, just conceded. I don't know if that happens automatically after a certain amount of time or what. Alrighty, old Flash Doomsday. So probably won't have fun in this game, but overall, I like Zatanna decks. They're at least a lot more fun than Harley. I think Harley I like in concept, but there's too much RNG. As I say that, Brenda draws me 0 cards. Thank you, Brenda. And my opponent simply goes face, as they all do. Because they don't really want to be playing a card game. They'd like to be playing Coin Flip Simulator, and they would like other players to play that with them. Okay. See what we can do with the Tana. I need a plus attack, I need a damage. Didn't get it. Unfortunate. See if we can find Pablo. Nope. Unlikely to win this one, I would say.
Ready to race?
That was very odd. Not playing. He doesn't have any silver cards to play. Let's see what we get from Crystal Ball.
I still have a few tricks up my sleeve.
So I want to play Amethyst next round with Jason Blood. Gonna play Brenda here just as a blocker. I know she's not likely to draw anything. Okay. First time I've seen that card played. Oh, I didn't actually know what this did. Sure. Wait, it goes through Aura? It's a hostile card. That could have killed Batman.
I've got a lot more than rabbits in this one.
Put everything into Zatanna. I don't care if he kills Batman. Here comes the Hellblaze turn. Wonder if he realizes that he needs to trade into Amethyst. No. Healing. So he's got one turn. He needs to pop the shield and then deal 6 damage. And if he can do that with his 3 cards, then he wins. If he can't, then he loses. It would have felt much more comfortable if I found a bandage, but what can you do? So he did not draw very well. He had to float resources a few times. Well, we only lost one game with the deck. That was the first game of the session, and I would say that I could have won that one if I'd played a little less greedy. The deck did very well. I wouldn't say that Andrew Bennett and Jason Blood did kind of contribute a little bit in a couple of different games. Seems like a solid deck. And it's fun to play. That's all for this session, and thank you for watching.